Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you. This is Vocabulary by Etymology, episode 18, Latin Borrowings. So these are the words which we are going to discuss in today's session. Augean stable, croesus, dragon's teeth, hades, lethargic, Midas touch, Pyrrhic victory, and Stygian. So let's start. Our first word is Augean stable. It's a condition or place marked by great accumulation of filth or corruption. Augeas, the mythical king of Elis, kept great stables that held 3,000 oxen and had not been cleaned for 30 years when Hercules was assigned a job as one of his famous 12 labors. This task was enormous, so Hercules shifted the course of two rivers to make them power through the stables. The next word is Croesus. It's a very rich person. Croesus was the name of a king of Lydia, an ancient kingdom in western Turkey, who died around 546 BC. Lydia was probably the first country in history to use coins, and under the wealthy and powerful Croesus, the first coins of pure silver and gold were produced. The next word is dragon's teeth. They are seeds of conflict. So, the Phoenician prince Cadmus once had to kill a dragon and was instructed by the goddess Athena to plant its teeth in the ground. From the many teeth, there sprang up an army of fierce armed men. The goddess then directed him to throw a precious stone into their midst, and they proceeded to slaughter each other until only the five best warriors were left. These became Cadmus's generals, with whom he constructed the great city, state of Thebes. When we sow dragon's teeth, we create the conditions for future trouble. Next word is Hades. It's the underground home of the death in the Greek mythology. In Greek mythology, Hades was both the land of the dead and the god who ruled there. Hades the god, who the Greeks also called Pluto, was the brother of Zeus and Poseidon, who ruled the skies and the seas. The realm called Hades, where he ruled with his wife Persephone, was the region under the earth full of mineral wealth and fertility and home to dead souls. The next word is lethargic. It means lazily sluggish. The philosopher Plato wrote that before a dead person could leave the underworld to begin a new life, he had to drink from the river Lethe, whose name means forgetfulness in Greek, and forget all aspects of one's former life and the time spent in Hades. But lethargic and its noun lethargy do not actually refer to forgetting. Instead, they describe the weak, ghostly state of the dead spirits. The next word is Midas touch. It's a skill for making money in every venture. Midas was a legendary king of Phrygia in Turkey. In return for a good deed, he was granted one wish by the god Dionysus and asked for the power to turn everything he touched into gold. When he discovered to his horror that his touch had turned his food and drink to gold, he begged Dionysus to take back the gift, and Dionysus agreed to do so. The next word is Pyrrhic victory. It's a victory won at an excessive cost. In 279 BC, Pyrrhus, the king of Epirus, a country in northwest Greece, defeated the Romans at the Battle of Osculum, but lost all of his best officers and many men. He exclaimed after the battle, "One more such victory and we are lost." The next word is Stygian. It means extremely dark, dank, gloomy, and forbidding. The Greek underworld of Hades was cold and dark. The river Styx, whose name meant hateful in Greek, was the main river of the underground, and the souls of the dead were ferried across its poisonous waters into Hades by a boatman. The Styx was so terrible that even the gods swore by its name in their most serious oaths. A Stygian atmosphere, a Stygian tunnel, Stygian darkness, and so on, describe the dreary cheerlessness of the Greek underworld. Okay guys, this was it for this episode. I hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode, and please subscribe to my channels. Bye.